Hey, I'm Dr. Ken Earhart of the Advanced Pain Institute. Being Louisiana-born and Harvard-trained, I'm very happy to be back in our community here in Louisiana to treat the patients suffering from chronic pain. If you or a loved one is suffering from chronic pain, please give us a call at 985-345-PAIN or visit us online at painexperts.com.
One of those on hand to hear the Manchac Port Commission discuss plans for the port was Dr. Bill Wheat, and the discussion now is to turn away from being an industrial park and toward outdoor recreation and education. What do you think?
Yeah, Ken, you know, we had a presentation today from Dana Brown, very beautiful set of plans that she's presenting that would incorporate a lot of activities for folks in the community, educational opportunities, kayaking, all those type of things that you would expect to see when you go to our marshlands. And I think in concept it's a great idea as far as that is concerned. You know, the biggest thing is going to be the cost. You know, where's the money going to come from? Are you going to be able to raise the amount of funds to do it? So cost is a major issue at hand. Secondly, how do you integrate recreational activities with industrial activities going on at a site? Whether that works, whether it doesn't work, what's the risk factors that? Ingress, egress into Port Manchac, crossing the railroad tracks, if you're going to have kids on school buses and all that, all those concerns will have to be looked at, addressed in full. So got a lot of work to do before they make any final decisions, but I think the presentation was well done, and you know, it certainly has room for discussion.
Well, there's been a lot of concern over the years about proposals for Manchac. When you talk about industries, it's hard to imagine very many industries that wouldn't interfere with the delicate ecology of the area. Then you have the camp owners along North Pass. They don't want a lot of boat traffic. So what do you think, this direction toward a more ecologically friendly use? I know it's going to be popular.
Yeah, no, I think you're right. A lot of the projects that was previously entertained by the port came from resistance with exactly what you're talking about, how it affects the marshlands, the sensitivity of what we have there, how it affects the daily life of traffic flow and what you're storing there. All those things made those decisions a little bit unpopular in Manchac, and I understand why.
What they're describing really would be a park, and you know, a lot of people have pointed out, why is it that St. Tammany and Livingston, they have state parks, Washington Parish, and we don't? I mean, if you designated it a state park, there'd be financing available, and plus those state parks, they make money. This would not be really a pig in a poke.
State parks obviously comes under Lieutenant Governor, and that jurisdiction we get reports on the incomes that's derived from that. I will tell you, it's some of them are more successful than others across the state, Ken. And so, you know, again, great ideas here. I think worthy of a lot of discussion and entertaining it. The Port Commission is trying to find their way through this process that they're doing. I think they're doing great work trying to get to that point. And we'll see, you know, where we end up.
When you work with the state legislature, I know you're looking at several road projects, and the DOTD, they put out a list of their statewide projects, and it seems like we're only getting a little bit. On the other hand, you tell me that list is incomplete.
Yeah, so we're working on several things. I think in the early springtime, we're going to see Highway 22 from Ponchatoula out to the high school is going to be resurfaced, a resurfacing of that roadway. Long-term goals there, we want to do exactly what we did on the west side of Ponchatoula on the east side, which would mean widening of that that roadway. As you know, Ken, traffic nowadays in Ponchatoula corridor is tremendously increased from where we were before. So we need to do something. We have a school on that side, on the east side. It's extremely important that we get kids to and from that destination in a safe manner. We've had several accidents at the Dunton Road intersection with 22 just in the past month or so. I had a fatality there as well. And so it's something that will be addressed in the about this time next year. We'll have the letting of the circle that is going to be right there at Dunton Road 22. So that process is in the final planning stage and will be let out for bid sometime next year about this time. So that'll be a traffic circle. We also have a traffic circle that's going to be going at Hoover Road and Sisters Road. And so that will be, we've already got the funding in place for that P1 on that, so we'll be moving forward with that very soon. So there are a lot of other activities going on that wasn't in that particular construction report. Again, I'm paying very close attention to Highway 22 on the east side of Ponchatoula. We have to update that corridor with the amount of subdivisions that are occurring on the east side, the amount of people living there, the business that's going to be coming to that area. We need to get people to and from it. And look, we have the opportunity. The infrastructure bill that was passed from Washington is going to allow funds to flow, and we want to make sure that we're in that ability to secure some of those funds to address those needs.
Well, on the economy, you know, a year from now, I don't know where we'll be, but for the upcoming legislative session, the state has a lot of money.
Yeah.
And I guess we ought to enjoy the good times while we have them with the coronavirus relief, the federal money, the hurricane relief, and all the rest.
Yeah, you know, we've been fortunate in the past year, a couple of years, and anticipating in the next session to have a little money to work with. It's federal dollars that are coming to Louisiana for many different purposes, or COVID relief that we had. Now look, there's negatives to that too. There was a reason why we're getting those money, is because people were affected in a negative way. And so we're just trying to address needs with a lot of that money that was impaired. And so, and it's not free money. It's not something that you just print and hand out to folks. There's a cost of giving money for different purposes. It's got to come from somewhere. So, you know, we need to be prudent. And we have been in the legislature. We're trying to address needs that are not recurring, to where we're not putting ourselves in a position 4 or 5 years from now when the money is no longer flowing from Washington, and now we have obligations that are ongoing. We have to be smart, and I think we have done that in the past session, and hopefully we'll continue to do that in the upcoming one.
So listening to all of that, how can we give a substantial teacher pay raise, as the administration will want to do, to bring us up to the southern average?
Yeah, so we, as you know, Ken, we raised the teacher pay raise for the first time in the last legislative session. I'm not saying that's an end point, but it's the start of where we need to be to get to that average. Look, everything is on the table. I sit on the Medicaid committee. I know our care workers that provide services to our disabled, they're going through a crisis right now because they can't hire folks because of the marketplace. We don't have employees to do that. They can find jobs elsewhere that pay more. And so they're in a crisis right now, even taking care of our disabled and our handicapped individuals in the state. So we got a lot of issues, and that's just one, in addition to the many that we have to address on the state level. I'm working very hard to make sure those folks are being cared for. So look, there's a balance to all of it. Look at the income, make sure it's appropriate, and spend the money wisely. And that's my approach to it, Ken.
What else do you want to share with us?
Well, I just want to tell folks, look, we're approaching the holiday season. Wish everybody Merry Christmas. Right here in Ponchatoula, we've had two beautiful events in the past week. We had our lighting ceremony that many folks just was elated to get back out and do. We weren't able to do it in the last couple of years. We served a little gumbo and potato salad at my office right there. A lot of folks just came by. It was such a good thing that people could get out and start doing things again in that type of manner. We followed that up with the parade that happened on Sunday, with the folks were able to come out and join that. And by the way, Ken, we had another big event. Ponchatoula played in the state 5A playoffs this past week, and I'm so proud of those coaches and the staff and Ponchatoula out there, and those players for the success they had this season. You know, they did come up a little short of the state championship, but that did not mean they failed. They had a beautiful season, and we're very proud of those folks.
Hey, I'm Dr. Ken Earhart of the Advanced Pain Institute. Being Louisiana-born and Harvard-trained, I'm very happy to be back in our community here in Louisiana to treat the patients suffering from chronic pain. If you or a loved one is suffering from chronic pain, please give us a call at 985-345-PAIN or visit us online at painexperts.com.